PFAS is becoming a household name in the US. There's a lot of legal drivers, but there's also a lot of technical and regulatory drivers. In the absence of a federal MCL that EPA usually sets, the states are coming up with their own levels, and in some cases, these levels are lower than EPA's lifetime health advisory levels. So our clients are becoming concerned, and we've been advising them on how to get ahead of the issue in states that have not started regulating PFAS, and in states where PFAS is being investigated as requested by these states, we're helping them come up with work plans and ways to mitigate impacts. I mean, the reason we are struggling with PFAS as a group of contaminants is because of its stability in the environment. And it's stable because of its unique physical and chemical properties. And it's these physical and chemical properties that lend it the utility in so many of the products that we use on a day-by-day basis. One particular use that is by the military and aqueous film forming foams are used to put out fires that involve a fuel. AFFF behaves like a surfactant. It moves really rapidly over the fuel, prevents the contact of air and oxygen with that fuel and snuffs it out so quickly. It's about saving lives. And right now we do not have a good replacement product that does not contain PFAS that can put out fires that rapidly and meet the Navy mil spec. So there are lots of great uses for PFAS, but unfortunately we did not understand the potential issues associated with it, and we're just starting to learn about its fate in transport and the environment and how difficult it is to treat relative to conventional contaminants that we deal with in soil and groundwater and drinking water. We're also doing research with universities on other things, like how do we optimize sampling? How do we myth bust some of the issues associated with sampling? There's a lot of great uses for PFAS, so they're found in a lot of the products that we use in the field by our staff. I'm very proud of the work that we're doing in developing treatment technologies that are destructive. Most of the technologies that we're depending on right now are conventional technologies like pump and treat and dig and haul. They're really removal. We're just taking PFAS from one media and concentrating it into another media. So coming up with destructive technologies is something that we're making investments in internally through our technical advisory council. So we're funding our own research in collaboration with universities, but also the Department of Defense is doing a fantastic job of putting a lot of funding in this area. And I'm really proud of some of the innovative work that we are leveraging with a lot of universities across the country.